The rising cases of Ebola in Kampala are fueling fear of a possible lockdown, with the Health Minister, Dr. Jenrith Acheng, saying medical workers are looking at more than 300 contacts of Ebola, most of whom are currently in Kampala at nearby Wakiso District. The State Minister for Trade, Harriet Ntabazi, says a lockdown in Kampala to prevent the spread of Ebola will hit both the traders and the economy that is still recovering from the wounds of the COVID-19 lockdown.
Things of hugging, shaking hands, things of staying together and, you know, sweating together. No. Those things we are going to discourage. If I sweat, let me sweat alone. Let's not sweat. If you are sweating, sweat with somebody you understand. Not somebody you don't understand. And that one is a word to everybody, more especially the traders, the manufacturers, the entrepreneurs, and everybody in the city.
Ntabazi, who was the chief guest at the 2 days trade show by Women in Business, organized by Stanbic Bank in Fort Poto, tasked to stick to the state guidelines so as to avoid further spread of the disease.
Being a city, you are vulnerable because you host many people. Kampala hosts 4 million per day who come in. Those who sleep in are around 1.5. But those who come in during the day are 4 million plus. So we need to be vigilant. My ministry is vigilant. We are going to have a series of meetings to meet with you people to talk about Ebola and see if the traders and the cage owners can put in the sanitary facilities.
The 2 days program organized by Stanbic Bank was aimed at equipping women with knowledge on managing their finances, especially funds received from government under different programs. The ministers advised banks to focus on improving the regional market.
It's been Tanzania? No. Yes. Now, you need to spread out.
The minister challenged the banking sector to put in place systems that can make it easy for business people to do regional transactions.
We need to spread more.
Recognize that as a bank, our responsibility is not just to provide basic banking services, but to take our offering forward and to help our clients engage and interact with their customers.
Report by Jonathan Singwire for the news.